Okay, so let's talk about how do we find the intersection when we are given two sets here. So we have set A and we have set B, and we are asked to find the intersection of A and B here. So when it comes to finding the intersection, so think about a Venn diagram here. The intersection is that space there that they both share. Right, so we're only interested in what they share, what they have in common. So if I'm looking at set A and set B here, the intersection of A and B is only the things they have in common. What do I have in A that is also in B? So I have a 1 here, but I don't have it here, so it can't be in my intersection. I have a 2 here, and I also have a 2 there, so I do share a 2 in common. There's a 3 in set A, but not in set B. There's a 4 that I have in common, right? And then I run out of things, right? Because if it's not an A, it's definitely you can't share it in B either. So the intersection of A and B are the elements 2 and 4, because those are the ones that are in A that are also in B. So that's really all an intersection is. It's what they have in common. So let's take a look at another example. So here we have sets R and S, and we're asked to find the intersection of both of them. So again, intersection, we're looking for what they have in common, what they share. All right, so if we're looking at R and S, let's see, I have a 1 here, don't have it here. I have a 3 there, but I don't have that here. I have a 5, not here. 7, not here. Notice everything in R is an odd number, everything in S is an even number. So they're not going to share anything. And when they absolutely have nothing in common, that is the null set. So that means there is nothing in common. You don't see a 0. 0 is actually an element. So you don't want to just put a 0. So you want to put the empty set because that means nothing.